Growing up in New York in the 60s and 70s meant a Yankee game in the Bronx, a sandwich from Horn and Hardart, and a Neil Simon play on Broadway. Over the course of more than two decades, no one painted more unforgettable characters or brought more joy to audiences than Neil Simon.
Officer! We just got married!
Did you miss me today?
No.
Thank you, Mr. Dooley. Next time you're in New York, just call me up.
Nah!
Stop that, will you? What are you doing?
I'm trying to clear up my ears. Nah, you create a pressure inside your head, it opens up the eustachian tube. Nah. 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 Nah.
Don't yell at me, Louis!
I'm not yelling at you, Bella! I'm asking you a question. Who does that leave to put up the $5,000?
You terrible mama, please tell him.
Who does that leave, Bella?
I would get the money somewhere, Louis.
Where is somewhere? Bella, there is no somewhere. You want mama to sell the store. Is that what this guy is asking you to do?
No, he didn't ask me anything.
Well, either this guy is very, very smart or he's very dangerous. And he don't sound very smart to me. So that only leaves dangerous.
He is not dangerous.
How do you know that?
They don't take you at the home if you're dangerous.
Oh, my God.
Where are you from, Jerome? 1427 Pulaski Avenue.
I've been in this army for 12 years, and I never met one damn dog face who came from 1427 Pulaski Avenue. Now, why is that, Jerome?
Because it's my home. Only my family lives there.
Oscar winners, Emmy winners, Tony winners. It seems a good actor just can't lose when they've got a part in a Simon play. And for some, it would mark the beginning of a great career.
Neil Simon cast me in my very first Broadway show. It was Brighton Beach Memoirs. Thank you. I read for the part four or five, maybe six times, and I did get the part somehow, and gave me the happiest, most fulfilling start to a career any actor could hope for.
Of all the indelible characters and unforgettable stories Neil Simon has brought us, few have brought audiences to laughter and tears quite like the story of Eugene Morris Jerome.
I hate my name. Eugene Morris Jerome. How am I ever going to play for the Yankees with a name like that?
In Brighton Beach Memoirs, we discover just how funny and loving family could be and what growing up was all about. All through the eyes of 14-year-old Eugene.
All the best Yankees are Italian. My mother makes spaghetti with ketchup. What chance do I have?
In Broadway Bound, we revisited the Jerome household a decade later, only to discover that no matter how much the world may change, family is forever.
And when they saw the Statue of Liberty, they started to cry. The women were wailing, the men were shaking, everybody praying. You know why? Because they took one look at that statue and said, that's not a Jewish woman. We're going to have problems again.
To these two remarkable plays, theatergoers around the world came to discover that the magic of Neil Simon isn't merely the wonderful words he writes, it's the unforgettable truths he reveals.
He created his own style of comedy, plays that have made us scream with laughter or cry at the recognition of something in our own lives, plays that will live forever.
In 150 years, very few people will be remembered from this time. But we will all know Neil. We will all know his take on the world because he gets us right.
Neil, you have taken the stuff of life, marriage, divorce, love, death, and written about it so hilariously that it took years for anyone to notice that you captured an entire time in 20th century American life. Thank you, Neil, for a lifetime of wonderful, wonderful art given to the world through the fine point of your pen.